Hello students, after discussion of the topic how much distance and displacement is traveled in different cases from our chapter motion, today in second lecture we are going to discuss what is the difference between distance and displacement, with which instrument we can measure it, and after that we are having the topic that is uniform and non-uniform motion and how can we measure the rate of the motion. Just recall the example which we have taken of that number line where we had written the different numbers of distance in kilometers. And we had taken the cases A, B, C and D. Based on that, few differences we can list out for distance and displacement. Distance and displacement is the first basic quantity of the chapter motion. You will learn so many quantities in this chapter. Quantities means any measurable characteristic of any object, any phenomenon or any radiation. For example, if I want to know that how long I am, so long is not the quantity. Quantity is height. If I want to know how much hot the atmosphere is today, we can have the temperature of that day. So temperature is the quantity. In physics, we are supposed to remember quantities as well as the standard units of that quantities. For example, if I am taking again height, so height is always measured in meter in standard unit. For another smaller and greater units, we are having centimeter, millimeter, kilometer and light year also, which measures the distance of celestial objects. So the distance, the height, temperature, mass, weight, momentum, force, acceleration, velocity, this type of number of quantities we will discuss in the physics. Fundamentally, basically, we are having always three quantities. First is mass, second is length, and third is time. Here we will discuss the two quantities, they are distance and displacement. Let us discuss the differences between them and try to remember at least four or five differences. So the question you can ask that is of 2 marks and you are supposed to write down 4 points on each side. Now remember, my dear friends, as I said just now, that the unit of distance is meter as well as the unit of displacement is also meter, because actually they both are the path length. They are the measurement of path. So in differences, do not write that the unit of distance is meter and the unit of displacement is also meter. That is not considered as the point of difference. Second important instruction, that please always try to write down the differences part wise only. That can give you the maximum marks according to the quality of the answer. Now, in our last example, the actual path traveled by the object. That means we had taken O to A, A to B, B to C and C to D. That is the actual path traveled by the object, that is known as distance. But in case of A to D, the object is starting from point A and the final point is D. So the shortest distance between final and initial position is displacement. So if we are having the object at O, origin, and after traveling distance till A, it comes back to the O only, which we are saying as position D. It means O and D both are same. So in that situation, the shortest distance between final and initial position, now final and initial positions are same. The shortest distance traveled is zero. Say for example, you are swimming in a swimming pool. You are going in one direction. That means you are traveling some distance. You are coming back to your original position in back swimming. So in this situation, the distance has been traveled. But the displacement is zero because final and initial position is the same. So at last, in our first lecture, we had discussed this point that it is possible that if an object is traveling some distance, then also displacement could be zero. So shortest distance between final and initial position is displacement. Then distance is a scalar quantity. That means it does not need direction for its description. But displacement is a vector quantity, means it needs direction for its description. So displacement needs magnitude and direction both. So it is vector, and distance needs only magnitude. So it is scalar. Now, as we have discussed the example, that distance traveled by the object can be zero or positive. But displacement can have the magnitude zero, positive or negative also. That means if the object is moving beyond the origin, so that is considered as the left hand side of the number line, and left hand side is always having the negative numbers. So displacement can be negative, that is the important difference. Then distance is always equal or greater than the displacement. When it will be equal, so we are having the case of straight line motion where we are not turning anywhere. So it's a single line straight motion. That means final and initial positions are one only, matlab same only. So in that case, distance will be equal to the displacement. Both will be same. Then if the object is returning back, so in that situation, the shortest path between final and initial position will be short, but the actual path traveled by the object will be greater than the displacement. Likewise, displacement is always equal or smaller than the distance. Last difference, we can say that distance gives information about original path. Say we are having this one position and this is the another position. So object is traveling in this way, then comes back, then again goes back, then comes to this position. So distance gives us the information about this path. But our starting point is this and final point is this. So displacement will be only this much. and displacement doesn't give the information about the actual path traveled by the body. So please learn these differences. After that we are having the next topic, that is uniform motion and non-uniform motion. You all are wearing the uniform. In many government offices we are seeing the uniforms. The meaning of uniform is very clear, that it is the same, it is similar, or it is equal. How it is related with motion? In our textbook, two examples are given in the form of table 8.1. That table I had mentioned over here for all of you. In that example, the time is given and two objects considered as A and B is traveling some distance, and that is shown in meter. The timing is given as 9:30, 9:45, 10, 10:15, 10:30. That means everywhere we are having the difference of 15 minutes. Now, the object A and B, say there are two cars or there are two trucks or one car, one truck, anything. In these time intervals, which is having the gap of 15 minutes everywhere, so first thing, that time is uniform. In this uniform time, object A is traveling 10 meter, 20 meter, 30 meter, 40 meter, 50 meter, 60 meter. It means in every 15 minute, object A is traveling 10 meter, 10 meter, 10 meter, 10 meter. So, in uniform time interval, the object is traveling equal distances, and this type of motion is known as uniform motion. Now what about the object B? Object B is traveling the distances as 12 meter, 19 meter, 23 meter, 35 meter, and so on. So if we are taking the difference, means in first 15 minutes, it is traveling distance from 12 to 19. So 19 minus 12, the answer will be 7 meter. Then in next 15 minutes, it starts from 19 meter and it reaches to the 23 meter. So, it is traveling 4 meter. In next 15 minutes, it starts from 23 and it reaches to the 35. That means it is traveling 12 meter distance. Then in next 15 minutes, it starts from 35 and it reaches to the 37 meter. It means the distance traveled is only 2 meter. Then you can continue with the same. You will see that here the distance traveled in equal intervals of time is not equal. So that type of motion is known as the non-uniform motion. I am repeating the definition, that if an object is traveling unequal distances in equal intervals of time, that motion is known as the non-uniform motion. In practical life, we are always having non-uniform motion. Uniform motion is an ideal concept. That means It is not possible that in every 15 minutes I can cover 10 meters always. We are having lots of hurdles, crossroads are there, some divergence are there, traffic is also there. So everywhere we cannot travel equal distances, so practically we are always having the non-uniform motion. And the last point to remember today, that distance can be measured by the instrument odometer, which is, you can see in the vehicles, it is fitted with the speedometer and the numbers which are changing continuously. While you are riding it, you can check it. It shows the distance traveled by the object. This could be asked to you in objective question, as well as this could be asked to you in numericals. So we will discuss the numericals based on this and the next topic, how can we measure the rate of the motion, in our next lecture. Thank you.